Hey everyone, I'm Matt Biilmann, CEO and co-founder of Netlify. And today I'm really excited about talking through our launch of Edge Functions. This is something that we've worked on in lots of different forms over a long period of time. We started as early as 2019, really thinking that as part of this kind of platform, as part of this cloud for web that we're building at Netlify, you would start needing a runtime layer at the edge that felt intuitive and easy to work with for web developers. We initially prototyped a lot around WebAssembly on the edge, but couldn't quite get the developer experience to where our standards are at. Some of you might have seen our launch of edge handlers that we took to private beta, that we've worked through with key customers, and that we built a lot of experience from. But as we saw this space evolve, we've gone from an area where edge handlers were thought to be maybe more of just a personalization layer, a layer for doing short transforms of content, injecting things, doing localization, and so on. And as the whole industry has evolved and more players have come to the space and played around with this, we're starting to see this edge runtime layer being even more of a streaming rendering layers that more and more framework authors are interested in building around and integrating with. And that's opening up a whole set of new possibilities for the web ecosystem and for how the Jamstack architecture can even look if we think about like this decoupled web layer that talks to all of these different APIs and services. We used to have like a model where either that would happen during build, or it would happen straight from the client in a single page application model, or it would happen from centralized serverless functions that just sort of, again, worked as endpoints that the client would talk to as APIs and microservices. Now we're starting to see potentially this emergence of sort of a streaming rendering layer sitting at the edge in between the client and all these different APIs and services. And we had to sort of go back and think, how do we best cater to that? But also, how do we cater to that in a way that feels aligned with the kind of platform that we are building at Netlify, that's fundamentally a platform built around the idea of an open web? And all the existing solutions that are sort of emerging all share the fact that they tend to be proprietary solutions, that they tend to be built on runtimes that only run at one specific vendor, and that you can't take and move from vendor to vendor. As we see the whole ecosystem grow up and we see flat frameworks built around this, that's not the kind of future we imagine for the web. The web should be built on open standards, and you should be able to write code and run it in many different places. So at Netlify, we looked through our own edge handler solution, and we saw it's more of the same. It's another proprietary runtime for the edge. It's a strong product. It solves some of the right problems. But it's not really aligned with our core philosophy of how we want to build our platform. So we started really looking deep and thinking, like, what is going to be an open runtime for the edge? What's going to be a standard that we can lean on that's not Netlify specific and that's larger than us, but where we can still apply all of our knowledge of how we build an incredible developer experience and an incredible workflow around building, deploying, and operating web properties using that layer? And after looking deep at the whole ecosystem, We started leaning towards a new runtime called Dino. It's built by Ryan Dahl that also created Node.js and has taken a lot of his lessons for building Node.js, but also really gone from like a platform that was based on an old world of servers and disk access and POSIX file systems and so on, to a new world that's built around edge compute and serverless runtimes and code running in many different places under isolations and with more restricted capabilities. So as we started talking to the team behind Dino, we saw that we could really create alignment here and we could really build a strong partnership by leaning into a fully open source runtime for this distributed edge layer. And that's what we've launched today with Edge Functions. It's a tight integration with the Dino runtime running across a global edge network and tied completely into our developer experience. We've launched it with broad support across the whole framework landscape. It's always been one of our key values to be agnostic to all the different framework and to stimulate innovation and new experiments in that space. So we're working with frameworks like Remix and Next and SvelteKit and Nuxt and Astro and 11T and have a ton of exciting demos and tutorials coming out around this. But more than anything, I'm really excited to see what the whole ecosystem will do with this. And I'm excited to see an open runtime starting to emerge for this distributed streaming runtime layer on the edge. So excited about the launch today and hope you will all play around with it, give feedback, and let us know how this is working for you.